Hey guys, Jewel here with J7409 Weather Channel. We're checking out the tropics right now on this Monday, the 28th of June, 2021. So let's just get right to it quick. Disturbance number one, boy has it done a bunch of junk, huh folks? I still don't think it's going to be a tropical storm, but there's still that chance. So what does the National Hurricane Center say? It is a well-defined low-pressure system about 190 miles east-southeast of Hilton Head Island, South Carolina. It's got a large area of showers and thunderstorms, mainly west of the center. However, any additional increase in organization of the thunderstorm activity, that would result in the issuance of advisories for a tropical depression or tropical storm later in the morning hours or this afternoon. Now, the low is forecast to move west-northwestward at around 15 to 20 miles per hour. That's a pretty good clip. And the system should reach the coast of southern South Carolina or Georgia by this evening. Now, if the advisories are initiated, the tropical storm warnings could be required for a portion of Georgia and South Carolina coast with short notice. No joke. I said that yesterday, I think. Regardless of the development, you're going to get a few inches of rain possible along the immediate coast of Georgia and southern South Carolina through tomorrow, Tuesday. Now, an Air Force Reserve Unit reconnaissance aircraft is scheduled to investigate this system this afternoon. Chance 70%, 70%, any way you look at it, you're going to get rain if you're in the southern sections, I think, of South Carolina right now along the coastline and moving inland, maybe even in Georgia. We're going to have to wait and see exactly where it tries to push in at, okay? Now, it's moving west-northwestward. Now, that's what's going to give it that chance to bump up into South Carolina a little more than Georgia. But time will tell. We'll wait and see. Let's check out disturbance number two. It's still a broad area of low pressure, but it's associated with a tropical wave, and that makes it a little different now. It's producing a small cluster of showers and thunderstorms over the central tropical Atlantic Ocean. Now, some slow development is possible through the end of the week. While this system moves quickly westward to west-northwestward at about 20 miles per hour, it's likely going to reach the Lesser Antilles by Wednesday night. That's what I've been telling you guys. Formation chance in 2 days low, 20%. In 5 days, it's up to 40%. Let's take a look at the latest satellite data here. It's very important to check out cloud tops in these skies. And let me tell you why before we go any further. You see, when these tropical storms and hurricanes grow, it's from the ocean's moisture that makes the energy, right? Well, then the rising air near the center of where the clouds are, that is what makes the heavy downpours of rain with these storms. And at the same time, it releases this tremendous amount of heat and energy, which is why the storms have such cold cloud tops. Tropical storms mainly have minus 63 degrees for cloud tops. Not always, some a little more, some a little less. But let's check out these cloud tops. Here's the one right off the coast here. We'll check out this cloud top. Minus 83. Well, looking like it's got some pretty good energy going on right here. Of course, we see some dry air out here. It's not going to bother it. We'll check some more cloud tops. See, it's already cloudy. That's 54. It's this main little section right here that we need to check out with this particular system if it's gone across the Gulf Current Stream waters yet. Now, this is the Gulf Stream current going up through here. Looking like where I have it set right now is a little later in the morning. It may be pushed over. I don't think it's quite gone over this Gulf Stream very hot water yet. That's something we're going to have to wait and see what happens with. When it does have a possibility. It could intensify some, but altogether, folks, I really think it's too close to land to become but so severe. Okay, here's the island chain. It's a little hard for you to see, but maybe you can figure it out. There's Puerto Rico. We'll check out the cloud tops here. Something I found strange. This is minus 59 degrees Fahrenheit. Not quite cold enough yet to be, but so severe. But this is something I haven't figured out yet. We have this system. Wednesday, it should affect portions of the islands. You'll have some gusty winds, you'll have some rain, but they're not talking about it, I guess, because look at all this dry air. My goodness. All of this dry air, maybe that's why they're not talking about it, but we're going to check it all out in a moment. Then when we come down here, we have more. This is 76. This one's going to be more intense by Friday for the island chains. Maybe some of the Dominican Republic by Saturday. We'll check this out here. 52. It hadn't got its act totally together yet. Down here, 44. As you can see, it's the cloud tops aren't that severe at this time. But let's go check out some more stuff right quick. Now, this is the Euro model, by the way, and I've got it set for around 9 a.m. this morning. You can see this is what they're calling the circulation act because that's what it is, but there's not hardly no vorticity there at all, folks. It's not formed at all, hardly. Highest winds right now looking like 39 mile per hour wind gusts in that quadrant. We'll move over here, 40 miles per hour. It's just getting right after 9 a.m. to cross over that very warm Gulf Stream waters where the Gulf Stream current runs. So we'll move it up a little bit. We'll move up to around 3 this afternoon. You can see it's still not quite organized very well. The winds are looking like 38 mile per hour tops, but that doesn't mean that it still can't form and be higher. Remember, it can change. We're going to have to wait and see what happens. So far as rain goes, we'll check that out for you right quick this morning. Looking like, yes, it does have some rain. South Carolina get a few sprinkles. Looking like the most part of the rain's going in right around the Georgia, South Carolina border, somewhere in that area there. That's what that's looking like. But this could change. This could change. We'll move up to around 9 p.m. tonight. That center has just got on land down around Georgia, where most of the center of circulation is. It's not a lot, but there it is right there. Winds going up now. Of course, the winds are always the most north and east of the storm, and that's exactly what this is looking like right here. We'll see up around Charleston what your wind gust should be looking like, 34 miles per hour. Now, after 2 o'clock this afternoon, we should get a real good grip on it, but by then it's going to be a kind of late for you guys to do anything. And when I say do anything, I mean, if you got anything outside you need to pick up and put away, so maybe these wind gusts don't blow it away or it gets damaged in any way, things like that. Now, when we take a look at the GFS at the very same stamp here, it doesn't look like anything hardly so far as wind goes. Now, I do want to go back to the row right quick if we can hop over here, and I just want to go to your sustained winds. They should hardly be nothing, folks. Look at this. It's like an average day. We'll go up here. 12 mile per hour. We're all used to that. But the gust might blow up now, as you can see. And this is around 9 p.m. tonight. You do, if you have anything outside, you like lawn chairs, trash cans, all that stuff, you do need to take care of it now before it comes on shore. And it may be more intense than it's looking on this model right now, or it may not be. But this is a general idea, and I wanted to share it with you. Now, as we check out what's going on down in the island area, This is Wednesday morning around 8 a.m., the 30th. Here, we do have this system. Let's blow it up a little bit. I've got one for Wednesday, and I've got one for Friday. So that's why, see, there's one over here, and it's going to grow. But let's just move this on up and make it a little bigger. Take them one by one. And here we go. Now, once again, this is Wednesday morning around 8 a.m. as we move up to 11 a.m. You can see it's moving on across. This is around 3 p.m. Wednesday afternoon. The euro has just updated, folks. Here we go. We'll make this a little bit bigger so you can see. Looking like just north of Fort de France up in this area would be where the highest wind gust would be, 53 mile per hour wind gust. I don't know if there's any more stronger or not. Looking like, for the most part, 53 mile per hour wind gust in this area, and maybe the island here, you're going to pick up on some of it also. So far as your sustained winds go, not bad at all. You'll be okay. The island looks like it's not going to have any sustained winds, 17 miles per hour. We're all used to that. No big deal. Let's check out the rain at this time, 8 p.m. Wednesday. Yes, you do have some rain here. All the islands might get some shots of rain coming in. Nothing severe. The most heaviest rain's going to be around now, it's looking like, Fort de France. But this could change too. So we need to keep our eyes on this and be aware. Now, I said I had another system. Let's bring down the size a little bit more. Here we go. Over here. Now, we're going to move up to Friday. And boom, it's all the way over here by Friday. Let's go back to around 4 a.m. Friday. So it's looking like you guys are going to get a double whammy. Not that it's going to be severe. We're going to have to keep our eyes on it. But some of these wind gusts are looking pretty stiff right now, okay? So here we are. This is Friday at 4 a.m. Our wind gusts are looking like 54 miles per hour again. So, you know, it's looking like boom, boom, boom for you. Over here, Puerto Rico's looking pretty good. You might get a wind gust as it passes by of 34 miles per hour. Looking like it's staying south of Santo Domingo at this time. We'll go up to around 6 a.m. on Friday morning. And it's moving a little close. Now, let's blow this up a little bit. Looking like Bridgeton, or Bridgetown, I should say. You might get a whopping out of this. This may go a little bit faster than I thought it would. So we move up to around 10 a.m. It's looking like it's going to go to the north now. Now, last evening, it looked like it was going to pass right over this area. But now it's looking like it's going to go north of Bridgetown. And once again, Fort de France, you guys down here, this is where the wind gusts are going to be the highest at 53 miles per hour. That's what it's looking like around 11 a.m. Friday. Do remember, this can change. Then, boom, you guys are in it again. Winds are 54 mile per hour gusts. Now, these are gusts, and you can see when we move up here, these are much, much less, 38 mile per hour winds. Everything in the red is in the 30s. For the most part, when you get in this blue, and the lighter the color it gets, the higher the winds are. So you can see the main area right here where this is. So I'm going to bring this back down just a little bit in size. I'm just going to let it run through. Now we're up to Friday at 6 p.m., 7 p.m. You can see how it's moving across. We are 2 a.m. Saturday morning south of Puerto Rico. Then Saturday, right now, around 12 p.m., the Dominican Republic. Now, you could get some gusty winds in some areas here. So, some of these areas right here are looking like 43 mile per hour wind gusts. Just south, 60 mile per hour wind gusts. Sustained winds shouldn't be bad at all. We'll check it out real quick here. You can see not looking bad. And so far as rain at this time, most of the rain, you'll get some rain. Santo Domingo, you'll get some rain showers. You'll get some rain showers anyway in all of these areas. And over in Puerto Rico, a few rain showers, but the heaviest of the rain should stay to the south. And as it moves on across, you can see over in Jamaica, we'll move up to 7 p.m. Saturday. Jamaica, you look like your wind should be okay. Hopefully, you will be getting some rain. We'll check out your wind gust right quick. Your wind gust at the highest points here. Let's see, right around Kingston, 27 miles per hour. You should be okay there as the heavier of the winds go off this way. And I don't want to go out any farther than this right now, but this is a good idea of what's going on. So people, make sure you keep up with your local weathermen, your local forecasts. These things can change on a dime. Next forecast update that comes out, or any information that I can get about the system that is going on off the coast of Georgia and South Carolina as it pushes in and goes over the warmer Gulf Stream waters, if it does intensify. Soon as I can get that information, I'll let you know. But you guys need to make sure you pay attention to what's going on too. Other than that, I want to thank you so much for watching, my friends. You have yourself a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. Thank you for donations you send me through PayPal. Thank you for watching my videos. And you do need to share this video. I'd like for you to share this video with your family and friends and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of what may be coming their way. I'd appreciate that a lot. Remember to subscribe if you're into the weather of all kinds. If you haven't, clicked the J7409 round circle weather ensemble in the lower right-hand corner. Click that bell and check off all to get all of my latest videos. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks for watching.